physicists have this way of simplifying a science problem. So you're trained to kind of look at the messy, complex situation and abstract it a little bit, simplify, throw away details. Sometimes it's too many details. Sometimes you don't find out until after the fact whether you've thrown away too much. But the idea is to kind of retain the essence or the complexity of the phenomenon you're trying to understand, but to simplify it in such a way that you make a mathematical model that can be analyzed mathematically. So the key, what a good physicist does, is they find that sweet spot, right, where they have just enough detail that they are truly capturing the interesting stuff. But on the other hand, that it's simple enough that you can actually analyze the model mathematically. And so that means not only that you can do computer simulations or that kind of analysis, but also that you can do calculations and maybe prove some theorems. And when you have a model that's simple like that, where you can study it mathematically, you can gain insights and then you learn things and you can bring that back to the original problem. And I think that that kind of skill is very valuable, not just in physics, but also in biology and neuroscience and other sciences. And it's really the contribution that someone with a theoretical physics training can do well. It's interesting, actually, neuroscience has people from all over who have come and started working on problems about the brain. And many of them are theoretical physicists by training. And they bring that. They bring that quality of trying to abstract and simplify in a way that makes a problem mathematically tractable. And I think it's made a very important contribution to the field and will continue to do so.